This is your daily dose of news from On Manorama. I'm your host Swati Ajit and these are the major news stories of Sunday, October 27th, 2024. Months after announcing his political party Tamilaga Vetri Karagam, top Tamil actor Vijay spelled out his political agenda and vision for Tamil Nadu during his highly anticipated maiden public meeting on Sunday. An Israeli airstrike on a house in Jabalia killed several people and wounded others on Sunday morning, Palestinian medics said as Israeli forces stepped up their campaign in northern Gaza. Asserting that peace can be established in West Bengal only when cross-border infiltration stops, Union Home Minister Amit Shah on Sunday exhorted the people of the state to bring in change in the 2026 Assembly elections. At least 50 flights operated by Indian Airlines received bomb threats on Sunday, according to sources. The Kerala government on Sunday continued to express its displeasure over the delay in central assistance for landslide-hit Wayanad. They highlighted that the union government has yet to announce the category in which the disaster is classified. Let's get to the details. Months after announcing his political party Tamilaga Vetri Karagam, top Tamil actor Vijay spelled out his political agenda and vision for Tamil Nadu during his highly anticipated maiden public meeting on Sunday. Vijay had announced his intention to contest in the 2026 Assembly polls, shaking up a political landscape long dominated by the Dravidian rivals DMK and AIADMK, with the resurgent BJP under K. Annamalai making notable strides in this year's Lok Sabha elections. Having unveiled his party in February, Vijay joined a growing list of Tamil Nadu celebrities who have ventured into politics. He recently introduced the TVK party flag and the public conference held at Vikramandi drew significant attention from political parties, observers and the public alike as he presented his vision for the state and outlined his political agenda. An Israeli airstrike on a house in Jabalia killed several people and wounded others on Sunday morning, Palestinian medics said, as Israeli forces stepped up their campaign in northern Gaza. Medics said the new strike damaged several houses in Jabalia, the largest of the Gaza Strip's 8 historic refugee camps, which has been the focus of an Israeli military offense for more than 3 weeks. Israeli Defense Minister Yoav Gallant said on Sunday that Iran is no longer able to effectively use its proxies Hamas in the Gaza Strip and Hezbollah in Lebanon against Israel. Gallant said Hamas was no longer functioning as a military network in Gaza, while Hezbollah's senior command and most of its missile capabilities had been wiped out. He said both groups are no longer an effective tool to be used by Iran. Asserting that peace can be established in West Bengal only when cross-border infiltration stops, Union Home Minister Amit Shah on Sunday exhorted the people in the state to bring change in 2026 Assembly elections. Inaugurating a new passenger terminal building and a cargo gate, Maitri Dwar, at Petropole Land Port in the state, Shah said the Prime Minister Narendra Modi is committed to the development of West Bengal. Bringing change in West Bengal in 2026. We will put an end to infiltration and ensure peace in the state, Shah said. He also said, in establishing peace in the region, land ports play an important role. When there is no scope for legal movement of people across the border, illegal modes of movement arise, which impacts the peace of the country. There can be peace in Bengal only when infiltration stops, he said. At least 50 flights operated by Indian Airlines received bomb threats on Sunday, according to sources. In 14 days, more than 350 flights operated by the Indian carriers have received Hawks bomb threats. Most of the threats were issued through social media. Akash Air on Sunday said 15 of its flights got security alerts and after thorough inspections, all aircraft were released for operations. The sources in the know said Indigo received threats for 18 flights and Vistara for 17 flights. The Kerala government on Sunday continued to express its displeasure over the delay in central assistance for landslide-hit Wayanad. They highlighted that the union government has yet to announce the category in which the disaster is classified. Revenue Minister K. Rajan said 100 days have passed since the massive landslides rocked the hamlets of Wayanad, but the state was yet to receive any assistance from the union government for its rehabilitation. The negative approach adopted by the centre in terms of the rehabilitation of Wayanad was painful for the state, he told reporters. Noting that the state had already submitted a memorandum to the centre in accordance with the Disaster Management Act, the minister said the union government is now talking about only the amount received as state disaster response fund. That brings us to the end of this episode. Thanks for listening to Daily News Dose, hosted by me, Swati Ajit, and produced by Vishnu Muralitharan. Follow www.onmanorama.com for detailed updates on the latest news and be sure to come back tomorrow.